start. Shri Sagar contends that this calculation is a clear act of overreaching the directions of the high courts and the judgment of the learned single judge as affirmed in special appeal. Shri Sagar submits that the director of education has not been given liberty to reduce the sanctioned strength that stood fixed as per the decision of this court. He therefore submits that even otherwise the calculation made is wrong, and without putting the petitioner committee of management to notice on the issue of the strength of the students existing in the institution. He further contends that the director of education, having travelled beyond the direction of this court, the impugned order deserves to be set aside and the direction should be issued treating the sanctioned strength as 17 in the institution. Shri Yadav Learned Standing Council submits that strength has been reduced, which is within the power of the director of education, keeping in view the provisions of section 9 of the UP Act number 24 of 1971, and therefore he was within his jurisdiction to proceed to recalculate the strength permissible for the purpose of making appointments. He therefore contends that there is no error in the impugned order and one post is still available for being filled up in accordance with law. Para. Having heard learned counsel for the parties, the strength of class 4 employees was the main contest in the writ petition and the special appeal referred to herein above. The same was contested on the basis of the stand taken by the state in the counter affidavit filed in the said litigation, where the state itself had admitted the sanctioned strength of 17 class 4 employees as per the government order dated 20-11-1977. The learned single judge has recorded this fact, and as such, once the sanctioned strength had been determined, then it was not open to the director of education to embark upon any fresh inquiry and redetermine the sanctioned strength after the judicial intervention had taken place. The director of education has therefore clearly overreached the decision of this court, which was impermissible. He ought to have proceeded on the strength of 17 posts as available in the institution as finally decided by this court. Para. In the event the director of education was proceeding to redetermine the strength, then proceedings ought to have been undertaken in accordance with law and not with otherwise, in as much as the director was proceeding to decide the matter only on the basis of the direction given by this court on 5-12-2012 in writ petition number 63-102 of 2012. A perusal of the said judgment leaves no room for doubt that the director's jurisdiction was confined to the observations made therein, which clearly indicated that the matter shall be proceeded with in terms of judgment of the special appeal and the learned single judge, which had been affirmed therein. Thus, refixing of the strength of the director of education was patently without authority in law.